Joseph Armone, also known as Joe Piney, was a notorious American mobster and high-ranking member of the Gambino crime family. He rose through the ranks of the Mafia to become a trusted confidant of John Gotti, the infamous boss of the Gambino family. Armone rarely used profanity. His speech lacked grammar but had a lofty formality that has been described as a mob Shakespearean style. He believed in omerta, the Cosa Nostra code of silence, was straightforward and direct, and highly trusted in mob circles. He was arrested and convicted on multiple charges, spending much of his later life behind bars until his death in 1992. Despite his violent and criminal lifestyle, he remains a significant figure in the history of the American Mafia. Armone was born on the Upper East Side of Manhattan on September 13, 1917 and was raised at 406 East 11th Street. He was the younger brother of mobster Stephen Armone, a Gambino soldier, who was rumored to be one of the gunmen involved in the murder of Albert Anastasia. Armone married Josephine Di Quarto, a relative of Genovese crime family capo Dominic Di Quarto. Armone was known for wearing thick glasses and had an arthritic limp in his leg from an ancient gunshot wound. As I said in the introduction, Armone rarely used profanity. His speech lacked grammar but had a lofty formality that has been described as mob Shakespearean. It is also said that Armone was respectful and polite to Federal Bureau of Investigation agents he would encounter in his time. Joseph Armone acquired the alias Piney during the Great Depression. At that time, Christmas trees were being sold by vendors on street corners in New York City. Joseph Armone ordered that a portion of each vendor's sales be given to the underprivileged. This gift was viewed as a component of his homage. As a result, Joseph Armone earned the nickname Piney. Armone followed his brother into the Mangano family and in 1951, after the disappearance of Vincent Mangano and the discovery of his brother, Philip's body, Albert Anastasia took over control of the Mangano family. By this time Armone had become one of the family's top earners. Joseph Biondo, who oversaw the family's involvement in the French Connection heroin smuggling network, was an associate of Armone's. According to rumors, Armone was chosen by Underboss Biondo in 1957 to assist Stephen Gramotta and Arnold Wittenberg in killing Anastasia. Armone was detained on a drug charge, however, before the hit could happen. He was replaced on the squad by his brother Stephen, who together with Gramotta and Wittenberg, according to some sources, gunned down Anastasia in a hotel barbershop. Following the success of the hit, Carlo Gambino promoted Biondo to underboss while he assumed control of the Anastasia family. Until the middle of the 1960s, Biondo held the position. When Gambino discovered that Biondo had been keeping money from the family in 1965, he replaced him with Aniello Della Croce, a former ally of Albert Anastasia. Before we continue, let me just go back a bit and share a little info on Stephen Armone. Stephen Armone was listed in Federal Bureau of Narcotics files as 14th Street Steve, a mafia boss in the 14th Street neighborhood of New York City. After Prohibition ended, 14th Street Steve started selling heroin and opium for Joseph Biondo. Federal drug enforcement officers apprehended Stephen Armone in 1938 for transporting 59 ounces of heroin to New York on an Italian ocean liner. Stephen Armone and Eugene Tramaglino bought Mexican opium in California and transported it to New York City, where it was converted to heroin, in 1942, when it became difficult to obtain heroin from abroad due to the war. Stephen Armone was indicted on charges of attempting to smuggle morphine and opium from the Bahamas into the United States using a fleet of small boats and a chartered plane in September 1944. Joseph Armone was appointed to oversee the heroin operations for the Gambino family after Stephen Armone passed away in 1960. A French drug smuggler and a Guatemalan ambassador to Belgium and the Netherlands were apprehended by the FBN in October 1960 on Lexington Avenue as they were giving 100 pounds of pure heroin to longshoreman Nicholas Calamaris, an associate of Joe Piney Armone. Another 100 pounds of heroin were found in stash houses in New York City. The amount of heroin seized was the highest ever. After instructing an informant to deliver to Calamaris at 116th Street close to the East River, Joseph Armone was arrested. The FBN also located additional French nationals who had met Joe Biondo, who had provided funding for the drug operation, at his vacation home in Long Beach, Long Island. However, the FBN continued to be unsure of the identity of the organization's financier, and Armone was detained on drug-related charges when he refused to reveal Biondo's identity. Armone survived 5 point-blank gunshots in the Reno bar in January 1964. According to the FBI, Joseph Biondo paid Piney daily visits for 3 months while he was being treated at Columbus Hospital. The same year, in October, Joe Piney was charged in a French Connection case for smuggling a ton of heroin, a street value worth $25 million, from France to the United States between 1956 and 1960. Armone was charged alongside crew member Stephen Gramotta and 10 other individuals. On June 22, 1965, Joseph Armone was found guilty of the French Connection heroin charges. Of the 15 years he was sentenced to prison, he served 10 of them. Joe Piney Armone was elevated to capo when Paul Castellano took over as head of the Gambino crime family, and he managed his operations out of the De Robertis restaurant's back room. The success of Armone, according to mob author and journalist Jerry Capici, is an illustration of how the American Mafia disregarded its official prohibition on drug dealing. Using recordings from a bug in Angelo Ruggiero's home as a source of evidence, John Gotti and Ruggiero were both arrested in August 1983 for dealing heroin. Ruggiero was asked to provide transcripts of the tapes, and when he refused, Castellano threatened to demote John Gotti. Frank DeChico, a capo, and the soldiers Sammy Gravano and Robert DiBernardo already supported John Gotti, but securing Armone's backing was an important step in their next plot. Armone saw a final chance opportunity to climb the mob's hierarchy after years of suppressed envy of Castellano's wealth and position. On December 16, 1985, Paul Castellano and his underboss Thomas Bellotti were assassinated outside the Sparks Steakhouse. When Frank DeChico, Gotti's first underboss, was killed by a remote-controlled bomb in April 1986, Armone was subsequently appointed by Gotti as his new underboss, and he was dispatched to Florida to oversee Gambino activities there. Armone, who was 70 years old at the time, was found guilty of racketeering offenses involving extortion and bribery in Brooklyn Federal Court on December 22, 1987. The last accusation being a 1981-1982 scheme to pay off a government official in order to have the son of Gambino family consigliere Joseph Angallo moved from a New York State prison to a federal prison. Given their ages at the time of the hearings, Gallo and Armone's convictions amounted to a life sentence under federal sentencing guidelines. However, Gallo was granted a final Christmas with his family when the judge granted him bail prior to sentencing. Similar results were given to Armone, but the judge said he would grant the temporary release only if Armone made a public admission of his role in the family and renounce his mafia membership. However, when Armone asked John Gotti for approval to agree to the judge's terms, Gotti replied, "No, we can't do that, it would send out the wrong message." Armone declined the terms of the judge's ruling in order to uphold his Cosa Nostra oath. Joe Piney Armone, who had been given a 15-year sentence, spent that Christmas and the rest of his life behind bars. He passed away there on February 23, 1992, at the age of 74.